Welcome to WebStylePress. I'll give you a few moments to observe this animation. These are floating cubes appearing from bottom of page, turning into circles and disappearing as they move upwards. Their speed and size is different from each other. This is CSS only animation by using keyframes. Let's create it. We have this HTML with this div containing class named as title. Then we have got our main area that will hold background color for the page. Inside main area, we have got a div that will have full height and width containing all the cubes or circles. These are the cubes that will turn into circles. Let's create it. In this CSS, we have got the title, we have got main area, we have got circles, then we have got keyframes for the animation. Name of the animation is animate that we will use for the cube. And then we have got divs inside circles. This is the cube, actual cube. And then we are targeting each div or each cube inside circles div by using nth child. So we have got 10 cubes to animate randomly at this page. Here is the title. Title will go in the center of page with fixed position. This is the title, WebStylePress. For the main area, it will have a background, linear gradient background color, and it's got full width and full height. Inside it, we will have circles container. Circles container will be full width and height as well. Position absolute, top 0, left 0, width and height 100%, and then overflow hidden. This is container for all the circles or cubes. It has full width and height with position absolute. Keep this div in the background. Your page content will come over it. Now each div in circles div will be a circle or cube. Initially cube, then it will turn to circle. Let's style the cube. But before that, let's be done with the main animation. Animate is the name of the animation displayed here. It will have two points, starting and ending point. This is the starting point, 0%. This is ending point, 100%. It will start from here and then end here. Starting point is this one and ending point will be this one. Initially, its opacity will be none and border radius will be 0. We will use transform property to move cubes upwards and to rotate it. Ending point will move cubes upwards while rotating them. Cubes will be at the bottom and then those will be displaced or will move upwards to minus 1000 pixels and these will rotate with 720 degree. Now we can use this animation for our cube. Let's create the cube. This is the cube. Initial properties for all the cubes. So cube will have position absolute. It will be displayed block and we don't need this property list style. Its initial width will be 20 pixels 20 pixels. Background color will be white. This is white background color and then alpha is 0.2. its opacity will be 0.2 and you see this one cube, it is going upwards and it is turning into circle and then it is disappearing. Basically, these are all 10 cubes that are going upwards. And initially, its position from the bottom will be minus 150 pixels. And this is the animation property in CSS. We have used this animate, this one. keyframe animation, and its duration is 25 seconds. It's linear and it's infinite. Now our animation has been added for all the cubes. We see all the cubes with same properties. We have 10 cubes, and now we have to target each cube and change its position, animation delay, animation duration, and width and height. This will randomize them in their behavior. For first cube, we'll have these properties. Left 25% and width and height will be 80 pixels, and then animation delay is 0 second. Now this is that first div. Similarly, second cube will have a different left position, different width and height, animation delay 2 seconds, and animation duration can be 12 seconds. And you can change these to your liking. For third cube, I am using left 70%, width and height 20 pixels, animation delay 4 seconds. Fourth one will have these properties. Left 40%, different width and height, it's 60 pixels here, animation delay is 0 seconds, and animation duration 18 seconds. Fifth one will get these properties and values. Left 65%, width and height 20 pixels, and animation delay 0 second. For sixth cube, these properties. Seventh cube, these properties. Animation delay 7 seconds and different width and height. And as you can see, these are looking good now. Eighth cube will be like this. And this is for 9th cube, and this is 10th cube. Again, left position is different, width and height may vary, animation delay is 0 second, and animation duration is different, 11 seconds. Save, and now the animation is done. You see how beautiful it is. At the end, all cubes are distant from each other, different in height and width, moving with different speed upwards. It will give a feeling of random particle system, but it is not random. We could have used a loop and used random function for the cubes in SAS, but that could end up in different result each time. We need a consistent animation with random look and feel for this page. So targeting in CSS using nth child individually seems perfect for this. You can also make the cubes appear from top to bottom. All you have to do is to change position from main cube and a small change in animation direction. This is the main div that we used to apply the initial style for all the cubes. What we have to do here, we have to, instead of bottom, we have to use top. From top it will be, so that one, and then second change will be in our animation, keyframes animation. Here, ending point will be plus 1000 pixels. And that's it. Now the cubes are appearing from top and going towards the bottom and disappearing, and cubes are turning into circles with different speed, different width and height, and different positions. And this is an infinite animation. It is repeating itself. But I am liking the animation from bottom to top. So let's reverse it, or let's change it back to what it was. Save. Now it's back to what it was before. And this animation will look cool with any good gradient background color. You see this background color? This is a linear gradient. Let's change it. This one. Okay, I hope it helped. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.